Hello, you've caught me unable to think or talk about anything other than PS5. The closer it gets, the more excited I become. There's so much to look forward to that picking just 7 games for this list was almost as hard as the wait will be between now and whenever it is we'll actually get to play them. So please tell us in the comments which PS5 games you are desperate to get your hands on. Meanwhile, here are 7 that as soon as I saw them, I was just like, oh my goodness, can we just skip to when all these games are coming out, please? Just cryogenically freeze me, Cartman style, because I want to play these 7 PS5 games right now. Okay, first up, Demon's Souls, which you may think is a strange choice for someone whose only Soulsborne achievement so far is to have given up on every single one of the games with a consistency of cowardice bordering on traitorous. I love these games, I love the style, the lore, the design, and I love running away whenever things get too difficult. Bluepoint Games' PS5 remake of 2009's Demon's Souls, however, just looks too good for me to ignore. You know, I'm thinking about how preposterously wonderful their Shadow of the Colossus remake looks on PS4, best water graphics I've ever seen to this day, and salivating over the prospect of what Demon's Souls is going to look like with PS5's ray tracing and all the other fancy things it can do that sound amazing and that I don't quite understand. It was this view that convinced me, a world as huge and beautiful as it is dark and terrifying. The thought of slowly conquering something that looks and sounds as good as this is frankly irresistible. I can do it, right? I can do it. This massive dragon thing here, the one that's as big as a castle, that's just background environmental detail, right? You don't have to fight that. Next, Jet the Far Shore, a game that personally ticks all my boxes. You know, it's enigmatic and chill and about jetting off into the cosmic unknown while thinking things like, huh, aren't we small? Isn't space massive? And look at these beautiful wave physics. This is very much my bag, a gorgeous sci-fi exploration title that describes itself as a game about carving out a future for a people haunted by oblivion. The music is wonderful too. It's by Scientific, spelt without vowels, who also did the score for Access favourite Oxenfree, a dreamy soundscape of otherworldly sounds that makes you feel as though you're floating peacefully over an infinite void. Don't look at it, don't look at the void, look instead at this beautiful game that's coming to both PS5 and PS4. And now look at this one, quickly, before it zaps into another dimension. Ah, too late. Ratchet and Clank Rift Apart is one of those PS5 games that I looked at and instantly understood just how powerful this exciting new console is. I mean, we've heard the talk about the new SSD that allows PS5 to load new areas almost instantly, but now we're seeing what that looks like. One of those, oh, so video games can do this now moments. Aside from that, this is Ratchet and Clank, a platforming duo who've graced every PlayStation console since PS2 with games that never look anything less than sumptuous. I mean, just look at the fidelity and variety on offer here. Seeing Ratchet and Clank Rift Apart in motion is pretty special, and I cannot wait to strafe, jump, fire, and hoover up bolts, seriously, get over yourselves, bolts, when the game arrives on PS5. The next PS5 game I've instantly fallen in love with is Kena: Bridge of Spirits, a game from Ember Lab, a studio with a background in film and animation, a fact which becomes obvious as soon as you see Kena in motion. I mean, look at it. I'm bringing out the old, it looks like you're playing an animated movie line, and I don't care who knows it. Basically, your task is to explore this lush world, and with the help of the affectionately named Rot, that's these adorable things, free a load of trapped spirits and restore balance and, by the looks of things, colour to the world. Platforming, combat, cute things, yes, yes, and yes, sign me up. Kena: Bridge of Spirits will be on both PS5 and PS4, so get excited. Okay, I'm actually quite proud of myself for waiting until the 5th entry of this video to talk about the fact Final Fantasy 16 exists. I honestly could have cried when I saw this revealed, and you know what got me most excited? Not the screen-shattering battles between Shiva and Titan or Phoenix and Ifrit, Not the fact the series seems to have gone all high fantasy again, not the chocobos or the talk of crystals or the pumping real-time combat, which looks badass by the way, check out that Marlboro. No, the thing that got me most excited was this screen here. That's right, Creative Business Unit 3! Be excited, everyone! No, seriously, this is the same team behind the generation-defining MMORPG that is Final Fantasy XIV, now lending their talents to a brand new single-player mainline Final Fantasy. 16 is being produced by Naoki Yoshida and directed by Hiroshi Takai, both instrumental in the continued success of 14. And if you don't know who they are, rest assured this means Final Fantasy 16 is in very good hands. And yeah, Phoenix descending from the heavens in a burst of golden flame and fighting Ifrit is pretty cool as well, isn't it? Hype! Our penultimate entry is Resident Evil Village, and I think it's testament to how fantastic this looks that I was sold completely on this game way before I even knew it was the next Resident Evil. For most of this trailer, we're looking at a load of wonderfully sinister and grotesque visual horror, creepy folklore type stuff, a horrible goat thing, weird symbols, all after hearing a sinister local tale about a girl disappearing deep into the woods after going out to pick berries.
What is it with that creepy story?
It's just a local tale.
It's only after all of that that we find out it's actually the new Resident Evil game, and I love how Resident Evil continually manages to reinvent itself with such consistent quality, while at the same time keeping a narrative through line that links every game together. The soul of the series is always the same, and you could argue that soul is called Chris Redfield. Here he is, enigmatically appearing right at the end of the trailer. Stick your fan theories in the comments, please. Okay, final entry. You didn't think I was going to get through this video without mentioning Horizon Forbidden West, did you? I was welling up when I saw the return of Aloy, one of my favourite PlayStation characters ever, and even more so when I glimpsed what Guerrilla have done with this wonderful, striking world. This is a post-apocalypse, a future so far removed from the fall of our present-day civilization that all that remains are these rusting architectural echoes, now almost unrecognizable in a world that shifted and grown around them. The Golden Gate Bridge, these skyscrapers that sort of look like rock formations shooting from the sea. I just cannot wait to explore this place, this alien world that was once California. And look, Aloy can go underwater now, and there's a giant grassy robot crab thing, and look at that grass, and Silence is back. What's he up to? Nothing good, I suspect. When Horizon Zero Dawn arrived in 2017, it took my breath away. Horizon Forbidden West has taken my breath away and booted it into orbit. Like, I'm not getting that breath back. I'm winded by how gorgeous this looks. Can someone just hold me until this comes out, please? So there you go, seven, somehow just seven PS5 games I want to play, like, right now. Why is time a flat line? Get in the comments and let us know. If you had to pick just seven of the PS5 games announced so far to play right now, what would they be? Give us a like if you enjoyed this video, and click that notification bell because we're going to have loads more on PS5, and you don't want to miss it. Thanks for watching, we'll be back right soon.